Hi, my name is Brent Bruning, and for the people who know me or been following me, you know that I am a master hand analyst from the International Institute of Hand Analysis. And for the last 12 years, I have been going around different countries to find these very special people and see how their life story shows up in the hand. It's based on a discovery from Richard Unger that the fingerprints show your life pattern. And this is a revelation. It is explainable because of the way that consciousness enters the body when the brain forms at 7 weeks and it releases all the serotonin and dopamine and DMT through the whole body. And since the time of the Greeks, they have mapped every part of your hand to a different part of life. So when the soul comes into the body or consciousness or however you want to describe it, comes into the body, the hands are just so sensitive that they amplify every experience and they end up having these big explosions that show a preference of that area in life. And that energy shows as balls, as big volar pads that later form fingerprints. You can look at the fingerprints and you can see exactly like a topographical map, what is the person's life preference, which is best described as their life purpose, what gives their life the most meaning by the area of that expansion. You can see a whole life story around how that person is trying to fulfill that in their life, as well as things they've struggled with, or the areas that did not expand. The day I had my book published, a guru who's pretty well renowned in the Hindu tradition was coming to Switzerland. His name is Swami Vishwananda. They call him Guruji. And Guruji's not somebody you can just schedule a meeting with. I tried through the event organizers and they said, you can't just come to the divine. The divine comes to you. So I spent the best part of the day wandering around Guruji, you know, seeing he's surrounded by literally 300 people, and there was just no chance. But I spent most of the day meeting some pretty remarkable people at this festival, and it was called the Just Love Festival, and they're all filled with love. When you have a whole life story about love, you develop these wave-like patterns through your fingerprints, and when you have six or more of these loops, then you really have a lot of love. That's a big part of your life story. Naturally, I was imagining what his fingerprints would be. Here's a guy who's manifested an entire community around the world, 50,000 people. And so he's built that up. So when he dies, they'll live on. And as well, they all call him, you know, it's all a family. Manifestation in general shows up in the thumbs. And when the soul comes in and it says, aha, I love this energy. In the area of the thumbs, in the left hand is your more inner side, the right hand is a more outer journey. Then if you have manifestation in the outward, what is that? That's just manifesting a business. And if it's on the more private, it's more about community, something more inward. So I gave him double shots. I thought, okay, he's gonna have a circle on both thumbs and he'll have these loops. So it was really cool. At the very end, when I had given up all hope, he walks off his, I don't know, throne thing. And he's walking off and he looks down and he sees my book. And he's like, what is this? And I hop up and I then flip to the page and I said, listen, I've spent the last 7 hours trying to figure out what your fingerprints look like. And this is based on this theory. I predict what I think your fingerprints are. And so I flipped it over and I said, I think you have all these waves. And you know, I look at his fingers and there are all the waves. He has these circles on both thumbs and I show him the circle. So he was impressed by that and he goes, okay, find me later. He invited me down to the bottom of this castle and there I met his swamis and he asked me to read all the swamis. And these guys live and breathe each other all the time. So they were very impressed that I was able to describe them in the way they know them. So I want to show you what his hands are and describe a little bit why he is the way he is. One of the things is he's got fire hands. Naturally, he has all these lines everywhere. And so people with fire hands are ultra creative. And they're around a very dynamic, very passionate, dancing, intense environment. The second part is, if you look through most of the people in the spiritual community, the ones that are really like anchored in spirituality, they end up getting this big round outside part of their palm, the area of called the moon. And that is the area of finding great world meaning in everything you do. So what's a fire, creative, intense person with this big moon? So I have on my computer about 20,000 hands. So I was researching to see who has that combination. And there really is only the saints mainly. Also, he has a big warrior side. He's got this area right next to the thumb. It's called Mars. And when this gets really big, this is a need to go over the boundaries and just conquer. So he's a spiritual warrior for sure. I won't read every aspect of his hands out of time, but the middle finger is really tall. And he has a vertical line that goes from the base of that all the way down here. So that is the line of discipline. So if you have a big straight fate line, that shows an immense amount of structure in your life. It has a pattern of you repeating the same thing over and over in order to improve on your day. Now let's put it all together. Who's somebody who has got a lot of creativity and dancing all around them, you know, singing and everything, who has deep discipline? He's a bit of a warrior, so he's trying to grow his organization more than likely, as well as provoke people in order to develop a deeper love in their life, and who has this life purpose of love. And the more he develops that love, then he develops this ability to manifest. Now, I want to underline this one little piece here before I let you go. The fingerprints show the shadow, as I was saying. And this is a really cool piece of wisdom that the Institute has figured out. In the areas that it grows a lot, then that's like your biggest dream to have. And all the other areas is like, you know, the vegetables you have to eat in order to fulfill that dream. But the people that really develop themselves, and they take the weakest link in their fingerprints. What the Institute sees is those are the successful people. Those are the people who are really making a difference out in the world. And the ones that try to avoid it, for some reason they experience too much suffering or fear and they don't want to develop that area, then nothing happens. They're really stuck in their life. And so this is a very valuable wisdom for self-help. And naturally, Guruji has loops everywhere. He has developed it to a phenomenal mastery level of love. And as a result, he's developed almost a magical ability to manifest things for all these followers. They all have stories of him just blessing their life and these miracles coming and them, you know, having this manifestation as well as rings coming. He's a phenomenal man. And I love this life I've got to read these interesting people. And I can tell you, the energy around him was so sacred. And that's the fire energy with spirituality. So as you can tell, your hands have a profound wisdom. They show not only your power and your talents, but as well, they show a code of your life path and your life purpose. And this is really important if you're wanting to grow spiritually. I offer a half-hour hand analysis as well as a two-hour hand analysis with a diagram. So you can find more about that at thepowerinyourhands.com. I want to thank the Bhakti Marga organization for the videos as well as introducing me to Guruji and to Guruji for showing me a deeper spiritual path as well as how amazing life is if you just love. So thanks for watching, and I really look forward to hearing from you, reading your hands. Thank you so much. Cheers.